Hey, how's it going, guys? Back again in the final whistle. Like I told you guys, I'll be back every day, and I'm gonna be promising that. And here I am talking about Javier Hernandez Chicharito. He last year was absolutely awful. I mean, this is something you could say about LA Galaxy in general. LA Galaxy were poor last year. They weren't up to their usual standard of the big MLS club, LA Galaxy. And they brought in Javier Hernandez Chicharito for around $8.5 million, upwards of $9 million, from Sevilla. Chicharito, Mexican, fantastic player. He's known worldwide. Won two Premier Leagues at Manchester United. Unbelievable box striker. I think there was a weird stat. He only scored all of his goals for Manchester United in a box. Something. It was an unbelievable stat. He's won the Gold Cup for Mexico. He's won unbelievable amounts of trophies. He might have even won La Liga while he was on loan at Real Madrid. I can't remember that, to be honest with you. But he's a highly decorated player, is what I'm trying to say. And I'm making this video because I think Hernandez Chicharito is going to be win the Golden Boot in MLS this season. He's going to be the top goal scorer in the MLS. I think he's a quality player. He's showed it all over the world. Like I said, he's very decorated, very talented. But the thing that shows it for me is his confidence. He's got off and scored very first game. If he waited till maybe the third game, the fourth game, and didn't score, or maybe just scored one goal in four games, his confidence would be shattered again. Last year, you saw a terrible Chicharito. You saw an out-of-form Chicharito, a guy who didn't have the confidence, who wasn't on his game, didn't have the backing from the manager. He just didn't look like himself. And you could see it when he went in the field. He was carrying the world on his shoulders. And you can just tell from a striker when they're not confident, when they can't score. You can see it in the Premier League with Timo Werner for Chelsea and for Manchester United. You can see Anthony Martial doing the same. And Javier Chicharito looked the same way last year. And you come into this year, two appearances, five goals. And that's just outstanding. He had two against Inter Miami, and in the second game he had three. The goals against Inter Miami, yes, it was terrible, terrible defending, terrible goalkeeping. But the first goal, he cut across the back line, opened up some space, and finished it very nicely. Goalkeeper could have done better, but he still was in the right place, made the run, made the movement, got the ball, received it well, opened up, and had a beautiful finish. Second goal was a back post, brings it down. Well, didn't really bring it down. Muffed by the goalkeeper, muffed by the back line. Should have been got rid of, but it wasn't. And he was there at the right place, right time. And I've said it before on this channel. Strikers have talked about being in the right place, like right time. They're lucky. They're just horseshoe, right? They're just lucky. But that's all false. As we know, if you're a big football fan or football supporter or soccer supporter, however you want to say it, striker's not a place where you're lucky. Sure, you got a bit of luck when you're playing up front, number nine, but that's just a striker's instinct, as Chicharito has. He's played in the game for many years. Like I say, he scores all of his goals in the box. These five goals he scored in the MLS so far, all inside the 18-yard box. He's never known for finishing outside the 18. Never. You won't see it once probably in the MLS this year. Maybe he'll score one fluky goal, something weird. But yeah, like I said, he's you can't say he's lucky when he's at the right place at the right time. That's a striker's instinct. He knows to be there. He's ready. He's going to be there. And that's where you look for Chicharito. And the thing I loved about, I'm going to highlight the first game because I saw most of the first game against Inter Miami. As you know, I'm an Inter Miami fan and Toronto fan. But I'm going to highlight that game mostly. First half, you saw a really quiet Chicharito. He didn't do much. And then you see Greg Vanney, unbelievable manager. The beautiful decision he made here. He brings, I can't remember who he brought on. I think it might have been, Bruin Place or Seattle. I can't remember who he brought on exactly. But he brought another striker to play up top because he knows Chicharito plays very well with another striker up top of him because Chicharito can drop back, plays a secondary striker. He can go up front and play as a poacher. He can play an advanced striker role. And Greg Vanney brought on another striker with him, and he did wonderfully. It changed the system. It opened up room for Chicharito. Chicharito was able to flourish. He was able to do what he needs. And you saw the best from Hernandez Chicharito. Chicharito does this with Mexico too, but Mexico sometimes plays in the front three, as we know, with Vela or with Irving Lozano or such like that. But then Chicharito played fantastic here in the front two, as we've seen with Manchester United, Seville, Real Madrid. He played it a little bit well. He's done it well wherever he's gone. He's played great in a front two. He's never been good with playing front three attackers with wingers. And Greg Vanney did this beautifully. He changed it mid-game in the second half, brought another striker, and you saw Chicharito score two goals. And second game, he did that once again. He played two strikers, and look what Chicharito did. He had three goals. Now he has five goals in two games, and that's why I think he's going to be the top goal scorer in the MLS. You got a coach like Greg Vanney, who's a ruthless winner. He's gone wherever he's gone, he's won. In Toronto, no one thought he was going to do well there. He did fantastically. And he's coming to LA Galaxy with a striker who I think he's going to love. Plays right into his style. He's going to score him lots of goals. He's brought in Victor Vasquez, who he had in Toronto, brought him back from Saudi Arabia to play right behind Chicharito, who's going to be brilliant behind Chicharito, feeding him lots of balls, as he did for Altidore and Giovinco back in Toronto. And I think Vanny's worked with so many great number nines. Iwakunle last year he got the best of, which no one expected that. He's always gotten the best of Jozy Altidore, which we've seen many years. And the goals he got from them is unbelievable. No one thought they'd be scoring that many. And then he comes and he has a striker like Chicharito. Chicharito's proven. He just needed Chicharito to get confidence. He's got confidence early on in the season. If he can distribute the ball and get the ball to Chicharito, he's going to be either, if you're looking at NFL, you got Alex Smith, who was the comeback player of the year, per se, or he was. This could be the comeback player of the year for the MLS if they want to add in this award, because Chicharito is easily going to win it, I think. He's going to easily be the comeback player of the year. I love Chicharito. I've always have. It hurt me to see him score against Inter Miami, but he's going to be the comeback player of the season, 100%, hands down. Mark my words, Chicharito will be either the highest goal scorer or second. He's going to be one of the top two. It's either going to be him or it's going to be Gonzalo Higuain. That's going to be my second video for the day, guys. I love being here. I love making another video. It's always fun doing this for you guys. Chicharito, top goal scorer of the year. Mark my words, and I'll see you for the next one, guys. Hope you like this player review, you could say, for MLS. You could call it a player review, or you could just call it a opinion, per se. But, yeah, we're going to do a play. This was a player review on Javier Hernandez Chicharito. Hope you guys liked it. Give me your thoughts. Who you think is going to be top goal scorer in the league. See you, guys. See you for next one. Bye now.